The Savior's birth was prophesied around the world. In the Old Testament, Isaiah foretells of the Messiah.
For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace.
People all over the world awaited the birth of the Messiah. In the Americas, the prophet King Benjamin taught his people about the Savior who would soon come.
For behold, the time cometh, and is not far distant, that with power the Lord Omnipotent, who reigneth, who was, and is from all eternity to all eternity, shall come down from heaven among the children of men, and he shall be called Jesus Christ, the Son of God, the Father of heaven and earth, the Creator of all things from the beginning, and his mother shall be called Mary.
Mary was a chosen vessel of the Lord, a righteous young woman living in Galilee. She would be the mother of Jesus.
And in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God unto a city of Galilee named Nazareth. And the angel came in unto her and said, Hail, thou art highly favored, the Lord is with thee, blessed art thou among women. And the angel said unto her, Fear not, Mary, for thou hast found favor with God. And behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb, and bring forth a son. And ye shalt call his name Jesus. For with God nothing shall be impossible. And Mary said, Behold, the handmaid of the Lord, be it unto me according to thy word. And the angel departed from her.
By visiting Mary and also Joseph, her soon-to-be husband, the angel comforted and prepared them for the difficult journey ahead.
But while he thought on these things, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared unto him in a dream, saying, Joseph, thou son of David, fear not to take unto thee Mary thy wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Ghost, and she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus. For he shall save his people from their sins.
And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And all went to be taxed, every one into his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, to be taxed with Mary his espoused wife, being great with child.
Meanwhile, in the Americas, the believers anxiously awaited the foretold sign which would mark the Savior's birth.
Now it came to pass that there was a day set apart by the unbelievers, that all those who believed in those traditions should be put to death, except the sign should come to pass. Now when Nephi, the son of Nephi, saw this wickedness of his people, his heart was exceedingly sorrowful, and he went out and bowed himself down upon the earth, and cried mightily to his God in behalf of his people, yea, those who were about to be destroyed because of their faith in the traditions of their fathers. And he cried mightily unto the Lord all that day. And behold, the voice of the Lord came unto him, saying,
Lift up your head, and be good cheer, for behold, the time is at hand, and on this night shall the sign be given. And on the morrow come I into the world to show unto the world that I will fulfill all that which I have caused to be spoken by the mouth of my holy prophets.
The time was at hand. The most anticipated event in human history was about to be realized. But despite its importance and celebration, it occurred almost unnoticed by those around it.
And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you, and ye shall find the baby wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men.
And it came to pass, as the angels were gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds said one to the other, Let us now go even unto Bethlehem, and see this thing which has came to pass, which the Lord hath made known unto us. And they came with haste, and they found Mary and Joseph, and the babe lying in a manger.
In Jerusalem, the Christ child was born in humble circumstances, but in the Americas, his birth was accompanied by an astonishing sign in the heavens.
And it came to pass that the words which came unto Nephi were fulfilled, according as they had been spoken. For behold, at the going down of the sun there was no darkness, and the people began to be astonished, because there was no darkness when the night came. And there was no darkness in all that night. But it was as light as though it was midday. And the sun did rise in the morning again, according to its proper order. And they knew that it was the day that the Lord should be born, because of the sign which had been given.
And a new star did appear, fulfilling the Nephite prophecies. But the Nephites weren't the only ones to witness the sign. People from around the world recognized it and knew of its importance.
Now when Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of Herod the king, behold, there came wise men from the east to Jerusalem, saying, Where is he that is born a king of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east, and are come to worship him.
Then Herod, when he had privily called the wise men, inquired of them diligently what time the star appeared. When they had heard the king, they departed. And lo, the star which they saw in the east went before them, till it came and stood over where the young child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceedingly great joy. And when they were come into the house, they saw the young child with Mary his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they opened their treasures, they presented unto him gifts, gold, and frankincense, and myrrh.
Just as the wise men presented Jesus with gifts, we also give gifts of love and service to those around us. And we remember the most priceless gifts of all, which the Savior alone could and has given us, an unlimited capacity to love, the ability to forgive, the opportunity to repent, and the promise of life everlasting. President Russell M. Nelson testified,
These four unique gifts will bring us more and more joy as we accept them. They were made possible because Jehovah condescended to come to earth as the baby Jesus. He was born of an immortal father and a mortal mother. He was born in Bethlehem under the most humble of circumstances. His was the holy birth foreseen by prophets since the days of Adam. Jesus Christ is God's transcendent gift, the gift of the Father to all of his children. That birth we joyfully celebrate each Christmas season with our thoughts and feelings so focused on the Savior of the world. What then do we need to do to receive these gifts offered to us so willingly by Jesus Christ? What is the key to loving as he loves, forgiving as he forgives, repenting to become more like him, and ultimately living with him and our Heavenly Father? The key is to make and keep sacred covenants. We choose to live and progress on the Lord's covenant path and to stay on it. It is not a complicated way. It is the way to true joy in this life and eternal life beyond.